Hi everyone, my name is Thomas Kim. Today is September 3rd, 2019. This is my 22nd episode about C# programming for desktop application using Windows Presentation Foundation. In this episode, we will learn the relationship between an attribute in XAML file with a property in code behind the file. More specifically, we will create a control by inheriting from user control. Without further ado, let's get started. Start Visual Studio 2019. Go to File, New Project. If you cannot find this template in recent project templates list, then you can select Language, C#, Platform, Windows, Project Type, Desktop. Then you can select this template. Click Next. Project name will be attribute and property. Solution name will be attribute and property solution. Click create. Right click the property, add new item, Windows Presentation Foundation, user control, my text box. Click add. Right click. Close all documents. Right-click the project name, properties, default namespace. We will change our default namespace to Talk Play Fun. Hit enter, then save all. Close it. We basically have three XAML files, application XAML, and main Windows XAML, my textbox XAML. From my textbox XAML, this class attribute, we will modify it, talk, play, fun. Copy, and also here, CLR namespace, I will change it to talk, play, fun. Now save it. In main Windows XAML, I will also modify the namespace like this. Also here, like this. Save all. Also application app.xaml, I will modify the namespace. And also here, namespace. Now close all. Close all document. Now click this button. Open appxaml.cs and change the namespace. Talk play fun. Also here, change the namespace. Talk play fun. Change the namespace. Talk, play, fun. Save all. Now press Ctrl F5. Our program runs like this. Right click, close all document. Double click my textbox.xaml. From toolbox, if toolbox is not open here, then you can go to view. Then select Toolbox. Click this button. Find text box. Drag and drop text box here. Right click. Layout. Fill all. Click this button to save all. Delete this text. Delete like this. Now save all once again. In main Windows XAML, scroll up. Here, local, colon, my text box. We created an instance like this. Right click the project field. Now control F5. So our application runs like this. Close it. In my text box .xml, we will create a brush here, public brush text background get return text box background set text box background value. We created a property called text background. Now save it in main window XAML again here. Text background. I will say aquamarine. Now control F5. Now the text box background is modified like this. I will drag this file. I will arrange it like this. Please note that we defined a class, my text box here, and we defined the text background property. This text background property becomes an attribute in XAML file. Please understand the relationship between attribute in XAML file with property in code behind the file. My textbox.xml.cs, this is code behind the file where this text box comes from. My textbox.xml markup file, we defined x colon name attribute with value lowercase text box. This text box and this text box are the same thing. So if we define x colon name attribute in markup file, my textbox.xml, it creates an instance in code behind the file like this. So we can access like this. Now I will create another property, public bool accept return get return text box accept return set text box accept return value. I will define another attribute, public string text get return text box text set text box text value. So we defined two more attribute, text and accept return. Then here, accept return true. Text, I love it. Now press Ctrl F5. Now the text changed to I love it. And we can enter multiple lines of text. Now I close it. I will add one more attribute, public bool accept tab get return text box accept tab set text box accept tab value. Now in main window, we will name my text box x colon name my text box. Now save all main window.xml.cs code behind the file. My text box accept tab true. Now press Ctrl F5. Now it accepts tab character as well, like this. I will close it. I will upload complete source code to my website c#talkplayfun.com. By the time you watch this video, you can click this link and download complete source code. If you unzip the downloaded file, you can find complete source code. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.